1 year later.
And what are we talking about 1 year later? 1 year later, around this time, I was pregnant. I know, I was so excited. Now, I'm going to answer the questions. Does it ever get easier? What, depending on the day? Short answer, this is not as easy as I thought it would be. Short answer, some days it's easier, some days it's not. Like, Father's Day is coming up. And that's when we lost our child. So it's really hard for my husband, who doesn't want to celebrate Father's Day, but he is a father. I understand why it's really hard for him, because he is a father, and that's the day he lost his child. And we lost the baby at 5 weeks and 6 days. We were so excited, we were planning. And now I have health issues right now. I've gotten certain treatments, and now I have to actually, wait a little bit before we try for another child, because I got the iodine treatment because I had high thyroid. Now we're trying to get with low thyroid. Oh wow, that was really creepy. The power literally just went off for just a second on this video. But my things, my like light and all is battery operated. That's the only reason why I didn't go off. But it does get easier. But what standpoint I am right now, I'm getting treatment and all that. Like, I literally have to sign saying I won't have a kid for just 6 months to a year until the, like, I won't try. And it's just hard and all. I know there's certain things, you're never really financially prepared to have a child. But the thing is, I say, oh, this will work good in our favors. Like, I'm trying to think positive. My car will be paid off. That means we'll have more money for the baby and savings. But, what's the realistic? It's so hard at times when you do have, everyone's having baby showers right now. And yes, I should be happy that we just got married. And I am. But, it still hurts. And it still hurts my husband, too. I would like to know, 1 year later, what did you guys do? We actually got our cats around the time we miscarried. And that really helped us. So that's, and I now thinking back on it, I don't even know how I would have made it this year without my cats. They are my world. I'm a cat mom. They came the perfect timing. And it's hard and all. And I'm hoping, realistically, I want one boy, one girl. But I've been told many of times by doctors that it's going to be a tough pregnancy. So you might just want to consider having one. And then if you don't want to give up your dreams about having a family. And you know what? I won't be greedy, but I do want a child. Me and my husband constantly think about it. I pray about it all the time, hoping that one day we can have a child and, I can show him how to film, and then my husband's gonna show him how to do some other stuff like video games, depending on what the kid wants. We just think about it. We sometimes talk about, oh, we want this for our child. Man, my camera tripod keeps falling, and it's because of my cats. They keep knocking it. So, gotta love your babies. But it does sting. Like, for the answer, it does sting a little less sometimes. Now, this is the first year that we don't have a child. And people will say, oh, why don't you try for another one? Don't even think about it. I was like, so my kid don't matter? My baby in heaven doesn't matter? I feel like that's a video that we need to address, us women. Things you shouldn't say to a woman who has miscarried. Oh my gosh. And even my husband agrees with this. what people have told me, and oh, it's okay, you can have another kid, it's okay, like, wow, that doesn't, yeah, I could probably have another kid, but my other kid didn't matter? You get my point? But I still keep the ultrasound pictures, and I will always keep those I still have my positive pregnancy tests from this. I wish I took more. It does hurt, and you know, I will always, when I have a kid, when we do have a baby, I will tell them about their brother or sister when they're old enough. So, what are some coping mechanisms that you guys came up with to deal with it? Like, I try to keep myself busy, but sometimes that doesn't work. Like, the other day at my job, a child called me mama, and I literally instantly just, like, bawled my eyes out. So, yeah, some days are better than others, but, you know, it's not like it's gonna, like, oh, go away. Like, you can ask me anytime, and I will know how old my child would have been. So, yeah, and I found that most mothers are the same way, because I'm in a support group. So, I feel like I'm saying so a lot, but I could do another video about this if you guys have any questions, or, like, how we should, like, support each other. Like, let's comment down below, especially if you've had a miscarriage or a stillbirth, anything like that. I feel like we should talk about it. We should be more open to talking about this. All right, bye, guys.